गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, माई नेम इज़ मंगलम अग्रवाल. इन द क्लास आई हैव स्टार्टिंग द इन्फ्लुएंस लाइन डायग्राम चैप्टर इन विच सम क्वेश्चंस आर पेंडिंग. ओके, सो नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट ILD फॉर द मूविंग लोड केसेस फॉर द कंसेंट्रेटेड लोड इन विच फोर लोड्स आर मूविंग on a simply supported beam. Okay, so in this question, four point loads of 10 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton, 5 kilonewton and the 15 kilonewton, which are spaced 2 meter apart and moving on an simply supported beam which is of 20 meter displacement. Okay, so we have to find out the maximum reaction. So this is the figure, simply supported beam of span 20 meter, four point loads of 10 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton, 5 kilonewton and the 15 kilonewton. Okay, so these are the four point loads. Okay, we have to calculate the maximum reaction. So we consider the two cases, when the 15 kilonewton is the leading load, and the second case is the when the second 10 kilonewton is the leading load. Okay, so when we take the 15 kilonewton is the leading load, so we just put the 15 kilonewton here, and from 2 meter space apart we just put the all load is here like this. So this is the simply supported beam of span 20 meter and 2 meter distance each load 15, 5, 30 and the 10, and the remaining distance is 14 kilometer. So we know that the ILD for the support reaction, that is ILD for the support reaction figure is like this. We just ILD for the VA is we just displacement of one unit and joining this line, vertical line. Okay, so this distance is 1, total is 20, and these are 2 meter spaced apart, and the remaining distance is 14 meter. Okay, so we have calculated this vertical displacement, that is we named it XYZ. Okay, so 1 upon 20 is equal to X upon the remaining distance is 20 minus 2, that is 18, or you can calculate as 14 plus 2 plus 2. Okay, so we calculate the value of X here. Similarly, we calculate the value of Y, that is 1 upon 20 is equal to Y upon 16, that is 2 plus 14. So we calculate the value of Y also. Similarly, we calculate the value of Z also, that is 1 upon 20 is equal to Z upon 14. Okay, so we calculate the value of Z here. So for calculation of the maximum reaction, we just multiply by the load into the vertical displacement or the distance. Okay, so 15 multiply by 1 multiply plus 5 multiply by X plus 30 multiply by Y plus 10 multiply by Z, and put the values of X, Y, Z from this equation. Okay, so just like 15 multiply by 1 plus 5 multiply by X, and X is the 0.9 meter, plus 30 multiply by Y is the 0.8, and plus 10 multiply by Z, and the value of Z is 0.7. so we just calculate the value of VA as 50.5 kilonewton when the 15 kilonewton load is the leading load. Okay, so now we consider the 10 kilonewton is the leading load. Okay, the case number 2. So when the 10 kilonewton is the leading load, so the load are displaced as 10, 30, 5, 15, and the distance are same 2, 2, 2, and the remaining distance is 14. So the reaction for the VA is just like this. Similarly, we calculate the XYZ from previous example. Okay, so 1 upon 20 is equal to X upon, you can rename as X1, X2 or X3 or X1, Y1, Z1. Okay, X1 upon 14 plus 2 plus 2. Similarly, Y upon 20 is equal to Y1 upon 14 plus 2, and the 1 upon 20 is equal to Z1 upon 14. Okay, so we just calculate all the values as 0.9, 0.8 and 0.7. so VA is equal to 10 multiply by 1, because 10 load multiply by distance. VA basically a force, and the formula for the force is the load into displacement. Okay, so or the mass into displacement. Therefore, 30 multiply by 0.9, 5 multiply by 0.8, 15 multiply by 0.7. so we also calculate the 15.1 kilonewton. So we just see that which is the maximum load from both the cases, that is 15.5 kilonewton or 50.5 kilonewton. So we clearly see that 51.5 kilonewton is the maximum load when the 10 kilonewton load is the leading load. So the maximum reaction is 51.5 kilonewton, and this is our answer. Okay, so this is a one more important case. Okay, so you can see from here. If any doubt, you can contact to me on my email ID. Okay, guys. So guys, in the next class we will discuss about the influence line diagram for the shear force and the bending moment. Okay, so for your understanding, the basic ILD for the shear force is just like this. Okay, the downward is the negative and the upward is the positive. This is calculated as A upon L and this is calculated as B upon L, where L is the total distance and A is this distance and the B is this distance. Okay, this is for shear force. And for the bending moment, the ILD for bending moment is like this. This is the L, this is upward, so this is taken as the positive, and the this point, that is this distance, is calculated as AB upon L. That is this distance is A and that this distance is B, that is L minus A. Okay, guys, thank you.